The first time we noticed that Zero D was a must in the shop, and it, particularly the powder shop, was some Class A parts going through high gloss black. We struggled with fish eyes, and I would say we were having fallout of about 60%. We did double check our employees and to make sure that people were following the rules, that you know, there were no deodorants, there were no perfumes, there were no hand lotions, that sort of thing from home. Found that some were using lotions from home coming in, and we did make the spec of putting Zero D as the only lotion to use. Started using that, and then we saw the defects go away of the fish eyes from those.
Well, hello, my name is Terry Welch, and with Prime Coatings, and I'm talking to Bob Seibel, who's with product development with Trek, and Bob has been in the paint department for about 30 years as a painter and then a paint engineer, and now he's doing innovative new product development things. When working with paint, as we both have for many years, we found that over-the-counter hand lotions that people buy in drugstores can cause severe defects in paint, fish eyes and craters, and some of the commercial ones are terrible. So we actually went out and designed a hand lotion. So we wanted something with all natural ingredients that didn't have any silicones or oils, that you could actually touch a bike and then paint over it without creating a defect. So I'd like to introduce Bob.
Sure, like Terry said, I've been in paint a long time, and most defects end up coming from personnel. As you mask things or decal things and they change hands and people handle them, it's pretty easy for them to pick up personal care products. And so we found that as we went to only using the Prime Coating Zero D, that has minimized the amount of unusual and weird things that we have seen happening in the paint department. So now in my role now in product development, we often will paint things and it goes to another part of the company where someone else is trial masking something and they have all sorts of unusual products on their hands. And that's something that we can really minimize in production by using Zero D, because that way we know exactly what's going to happen. It's very predictable.
We incorporate Zero D on a daily basis. With a lot of the product that we do, it takes masking, decaling, a lot of hands-on techniques that require without glove interaction with the parts. Typically, parts of that caliber have a lot of processes. They have a lot of touch time, a lot of prepping, masking, painting, you name it. But there's a lot of interaction from the human perspective.
A lot of times when you're working with paint, you can't wear gloves all the time. You inevitably get some paint on your hands, and we do some really cool stuff with Prime that has dyes in it, and it can get on your skin. And so for the end of the day, you take some solvent, try to get all that off your hands, and it leaves your hands really a mess. It defats the skin, it looks terrible, it feels bad. So what I usually do, another use for this, is I can use the Zero D afterwards to help lubricate my hands and get them back to normal so that I don't look like I have something on my hands anymore.
Gloves can be misleading, because a lot of times you don't know you've touched something that actually will transfer it onto the part. So typically just fingers can be the best method of handling a part, especially right. When it comes to Class A finishing. I mean, a lot of the employees are really happy from the perspective of it's an option, right? You can either say nothing is the spec or giving them an alternate, because when you're putting graphics on and your hands are in water for a long period of time, you really do find out that your hands crack and they get worn down. So just having that option for them really makes the employees happy.